Hi, good evening. Yeah, it's our second to the last class. Okay, so let's begin with the grammar part in lesson 4.3. We start at page 43. Okay. Do you feel warm in here? Is it warm to you?
Hope it's a little hot now.
Hoima. Maybe someone could adjust the air conditioner or something if you feel warm. Okay. So, grammar part and direct questions. What does it mean? Indirect questions. Direct questions means you ask something with a question mark at the end. While indirect question means you have to use period mark. Okay, like the question would be, how far is the station? That's direct question. You ask the person about the question directly, right? With the question mark at the end. And indirect question would be, do you know how far the station is? That's indirect question. Okay, so can we figure out the rules? Indirect questions with be verb should be question word plus subject plus be verb. 在这个间接问句里面的话, be 动词会放到最后面去。 句子呢？句子原本是 SV 或者是 O 对不对？这是一般的句子，这个叫正装。正常的句子的语序叫正装。那如果你要变成疑问句的话，是不是会变成 VS 加个问号？Do you 那个 do 是动词嘛？助动词是动词，这个叫倒装。 比如说 how far is it 那个已经是倒装了，可是你现在啊 ，do you know？ 前面已经主词动词已经相反了，那你后面就不要再倒装了，这样子。所以间接问的那一部分就不用再倒一遍了。很多人会说，Do you know how far is the station？ 不需要这样子。 那回答呢? 我不知道。 No, I don't know how far the station is. 一样不会变嘛。 所以你懂我的意思吗? 这个我把它换个颜色把它换回来。 真正问句的成分是黑色的字, 这边已经倒过了。 主词动词已经倒过来了，所以这边蓝色已经不是问句啦，它就不用再倒。这个是你会觉得这没什么，可是各位在写作的时候都会错呢。好的。 那第二个蓝色的句子呢 ？Where can I get a taxi？ 我在哪儿可以搭车呢？这已经是个问句了，对不对？你把它换成间接问句。Could you tell me where I can get a taxi? I can get, 这样才是正常的。I, 主词 can get, 动词。好，再来 ,What time does the train arrive? 诶，这已经倒过来了，那你把它换成间接问句呢？一个句子只能倒一次，你不能全部都倒，所以 Do you know what time the train arrives?好，那这样子你看一下右边 ，end a question with main verbs 一般动词。好，动词分两种，一个叫 be 动词，一个叫一般动词。或者是一般动词的话呢，你先前面有个问句，加上主词 subject。好，你看左边那个第三句就是了。Do you know question word what time the train 主词 arrives？ 好，动词放在最后面。其实规则你不记也没关系，你只要知道一个句子不要倒两遍，这样就好了嘛。你真的在写作的时候，你不会记得这些规则，你只要知道我不能倒两遍就好了。然后那最后一个句子呢 ？Is the museum open? Do you know if the museum is open? 这边的 if 是指是否、是非、是不是、是否，不是如果哦，这边是。是不是开着的？好，台式中文叫有没有开？不懂我在讲什么？你懂？
就是它不是开着，是不是开着？它的意思不是说是开着吗？还是说是？对不起，
就营业中的意思。营业中，那中文应该说是开着吗？啊，营业中吗？营业吗？这样子开门吗？可是台湾人的台式中文都说有没有开，有开没有开。
他可不可以用 open yet？
不用。假设他是八点开门，可是你中午十二点的时候还是叫 open。那如果你说 open yet， 变成是有没有人去开了门了？现在八点了吗？有人去开门了吗？这样子，意思会稍微不一样。It's open 就好了。所以这个文法其实不难吧？那我们直接看一下下面的句子好吗？因为下一周是最后一周了，你就不要写太多作业，在这边口头把它结束掉。那我们刚好，我预计刚好在结业那一天可以把第四单元整个上完，超出我们预期一个单元。So first question, how much is that?你可以告诉我 how much is it 吗？你看中文很简单吧，多少钱？你可以告诉我多少钱吗？都不会变，但是英文要变。记得啊，不可以倒两次，所以 could you tell me how much that is？ 对。其实你只要改一个字，对不对？你自己用笔把它画个 S 型，好像就对了。Okay, number two, where can I get an application form? 叫申请书。好，你知道哪里可以拿到申请书吗？哪里有申请书吗 ？Do you know where I can get an application form? I can.前面问过了，后面就不要再问了。Okay, number three, do you have any postage stamps? 好，你有邮票吗？好，再他问说 ，Do you know? 你知道你是不是有邮票呢？这句话很奇怪，但他的确是这样问。对方有没有邮票，还要你知不知道对方有没有邮票。Do you know you have any postage stamps? 好，那个 do 就不见了，你把 do 拿掉就对了。我再念一次哦 ，Do you know 后面间接问句 ，You have any postage stamps？ 听起来很奇怪，但是它是蛮礼貌的问法。不知道刚好你身上会不会刚好带着一张邮票呢？以为每个邮局员工身上都会带邮票。Okay, number four. How far is it to the library？到图书馆要多远呢？你知道到图书馆要多远吗？礼貌的问法。Do you know how far？ 好，再倒回来，倒倒得正。The library is， 对不对 ？be 动词放后面了。Do you know how far？The library is， 对吧？啊，如果你是要把整句话完整的写下来的人，你也可以写 ，Do you know how far it is to the library？ 刚刚是有人写这个句子的吧？好，难怪各位一头雾水，对不起。解答也是跟我想象的不一样。Okay, is there a post office near here? 这附近有邮局吗？你可以告诉我这附近有没有邮局吗？礼貌的说法。Could you tell me? 为什么它造句就是跟邮局有关呢？好巧。Okay, number six. What time is it? 你知道几点吗？礼貌的说法。Do you know what time it is? 没有错，你把动词放回它原本的位置。Okay. So pretty easy. So let's move on to our reading part.Yeah, reading part is about England. Yeah, England. Okay, so section 1A, what words comes to mind? What words come to mind when you think about England and the English? Now, England 是哪一个地方？英国，好像这样说是不对的。英格兰岛，英格兰。如果我们现在广义说的英国，其实叫做不列颠王国，对不对？那个联合王国是包含的苏格兰、威尔斯、北爱尔兰，还有英格兰这四个部分才可以叫 Britain。所以如果你讲 England 的话，其实只有那一块最大块的岛，是这样子的。在欧洲很多地方是这样。例如你说荷兰，你会怎么说呢？Holland 只有两个省。好，你讲 Holland 是只有两个省 ，North Holland 北 Holland 跟南 Holland， 其实他们国家的名字叫做 Netherlands，the Netherlands 低地王国，他们的名字很难听，叫低地王国。对，很低，他们的国家领土都是低于海平面嘛。那他们有九个省，只有其中两个省才叫 Holland。如果你说 Are you from Holland？他可能回你不是 ，I'm not from Holland， 我是从其他省份来的，这样子。好，所以这个后面的 the English 又是指什么呀？英文这个语言吗？不 ，English 指的是英格兰人。那如果加个 the 呢？指这个民族，就是通称的意思。所以英格兰这个民族，事实上在人类学的角度上，没有英格兰人这个民族。它是一个混合的，那边的血统是乱七八糟的，比台湾还要再更多元。它没有一个血统叫做英格兰血统，没有这个血统。好 ，So here are some words like first one, being polite. On your textbook, being polite. What does it mean by being polite? 有礼貌。
嗯。OK。那不礼貌呢
？Impolite 加个 I M 的前面 ，impolite。Okay, so someone is impolite. 他很无礼，很失礼。Okay, next one, English food. 英格兰的食物。哎，事实上有英格兰食物吗？也没有，它就是一个没有民族、没有文化，它当然没有自己的食物啊。你去英国，你会想到要吃什么吗？哎，好道地的英格兰传统料理有吗？有这个东西吗？茶是从东方传过去的。
他们有 black tea 不是？
嗯，但那个 black tea 是一种茶叶的烘焙，把它烘到全熟叫红茶。对，生茶叫做绿茶。那烘的，然后加个东西，就变成什么普洱那类的，那是从东方传过去的，它原本叫茶。对呀、啊，它原本叫茶。啊，它从厦门，英国人到厦门做生意的时候发现这个东西，那厦门当地人讲茶，它就 T E， 然后就传回去欧洲。对，那因为年代的关系，所以。有它拼字就拼成就多个 A， 然后呢再经过年代，哎 ，E A 念成 E T， 像法文的茶是这样子念，念这个不发音念成 T， 对，那德文是这样 T E 念成 T， 那西班牙文跟意大利文就是念成这样 D， 对，就是 D， 就是 D。那它根本就不是一个一致性的民族，所以它没有自己的食物，他们都吃。外来的食物，嗯、真的。哎，这边你去过英格兰吗？就是你，
就是你去澳洲啊。
你去澳洲，不是英格兰。我知道你去过澳洲，去过美国，去过日本、韩国。我知道你已经。
我们去过那么多地
方，好的。以前同学们他们到英国去留学，都说每天都吃薯条。吃意大利面啊，薯条是哪里的？是美国的。意大利面是意大利的，吃汉堡也是德国或美国的。吃印度料理卷饼，印度的。吃日本料理，吃寿司是日本的，它根本没有 English food。Okay, next one, the weather 天气。再下一个呢 ？Soccer
足球，
这是哪一种足球啊？圆的有黑白斑点的那个吗？对。好，那因为写书的人是美国人，所以他写 soccer。那如果在英国当地，他得叫 football。而如果你是圆的，美国跟英国，美国叫 soccer， 英国叫 football。那如果是椭圆形的呢？美国叫 football， 英国叫 rugby。好的，那上面两个的游戏规则是一样的，下面两个游戏规则不一样，所以这边有三种运动。这个叫美式橄榄球，这个叫英式橄榄球，这样子。Okay, so next one. Library. 图书馆。好，如果你把每个字都拆开念，音节拆开念 library， 可是你在口语中，你通常只会听到 library， 啊，因为那个 r 他们也觉得很难，就不见了。Next one, drinking tea， 喝茶。Okay, driving habits， 开车的习惯。好，这些是关于英格兰你会想到的词吗？Or what else can you think of? fish and chips, 就是我刚刚说他们每天吃的东西。好，就是炸鱼条跟鱼片，炸洋鱼片，芋头的芋 ，chips。And what? You mean queen?
Twinning tea.
Twinning tea. What is it? Is it a sort of tea? Ah, so also tea. Okay. How does it taste like?哦，哎，当在全家买，那 Seven 有在买吗？没有在。好，没有在。What else can you think of when it comes to England?
Lilinchi?
Is a 007 film named England? Really? It's shot in England.哦，口音是英国腔。And how about Harry Potter? That's totally English. Harry Potter. That's 英国作家写的电影 的小说，然后拍也都是用英国人啊，对吧？只有我知道。这我们看的电影不一样，你们看《零零七》，对不对？大哥们看《零零七》，小弟们看《哈利波特》。你是大哥没有错，你是大哥。Okay, so I have two films for you, two video clips about England. So, how about we watch it?铁桥是吗？然后这是大笨钟 ，Big Man， 双层巴士。
那个军人
这样。巴士不对吗？巴士啊。没有声音。看不到吗？为什么没人告诉我？哦，这句话什么意思呢？英女王拥有世界上六分之一的领土。
Number two.The UK comprises of four countries, England, Northern Ireland, Scotland, and Wales, and 14 overseas territories.
好，到这边什么意思？在他英国内地，在英国本土就有四个组成，在海外有这些占领地，对不对？是原本更多啊，只是大部分都独立，剩下这些其实还没有独立哦，你去查。政治上面的名称，或者英属什么什么什么，那真的就是英国。
Each country has its own system of administration. Number three. Kate Middleton is credited with boosting the UK economy by £1 billion in 2012. Number four.On the 9th of September 2015.Queen Elizabeth II became the longest reigning UK monarch ever.
So, the reign 是指统治的意思，所以她是英国史上统治在位最久的女王，或是国王，反正她是在位最久的。
Passing Queen Victoria.
应该不是因为她没被换掉，是她活很久。
Number 5. The keep calm and carry on slogan was originally dreamt up as a way of preserving morale in the event of a Nazi invasion of Britain. Number 6. British people drink 165 million cups of tea every day.
一天要喝掉165百万是多少? 1亿6500万杯的茶 一天 怎么可能那么多?
Number 7. There is only a 34-kilometer long gap between England and France, and the countries are connected by the Channel Tunnel.
所以英国本土跟法国的领土只相隔34公里远，所以他们的高铁欧洲之星可以直接从巴黎开到伦敦，经由地下的海底隧道。然后呢，那一趟票相等于台北的高铁票到高雄。所以看台湾高铁票有多贵，人家是跨国，他是跨国，你是要登。 是要护照拿出来给他看的那种，这样高铁票一趟的钱跟我们台北到高雄差不多。我朋友说只要1700，就是真的跟台湾差不多。所以台湾高铁真的是，暴利。
Number 8. The name Big Ben does not refer to the famous clock, but actually to the bell.
好，他说大笨钟的 Big Ben 其实不是这座灯塔，而是那个声音，听起来很笨重吗？啊 ，bang bang bang。
Number 9. London was the first city in the world to have an underground subway system.
Oh, so he said London is the first city in the world to have an underground subway system.
Number 10. There have been over 10 reported sightings of Nessie venturing around Loch Ness in Scotland.
这个讲超级快，所以我把它调慢一点。0.75还是蛮快的。但这个讲的是美国人。
United Kingdom, England, Great Britain, are these three the same place? Are they different places?
解释喽，这已经是0.75倍喽。
Who knows the answers to these questions? I do.
好，他说这三个专有名词一样吗？
This is the world. This is the European continent, and this is the place we have to untangle.
好，所以它这个国家是由4个国家组成的一个国家。
To the north is Scotland, shown in blue, and to the west is Wales, shown in white. And often forgotten, even by those who live in the United Kingdom, is Northern Ireland, shown in
white. 好，这边我打岔一下，他这边明明就没有接在一起，但他为什么可以统治到那一块？但是因为以前在英格兰呢，他是很强的国家嘛，强的就会想要干嘛？并吞别人，所以他是强行哦，他是把人家这样抢下来，整个全部都被他统治了，但是这一块的人，他们很强硬。 我们不想要被统治，我们的语言文化都会消失，所以他们就想要独立，因为他们那个时候英国政府在那边实施很多语言政策、文化政策，比如说在学校不可以讲爱尔兰语，你讲爱尔兰语会被老师羞辱、会罚站，上面挂牌子写我不说爱尔兰语，真的，跟台湾很像，对不对？那这些人他们就后来独立了，那偏偏这一块英国就死不还他们，因为如果全部都还他们，这以后想要再抢过来就很难。 所以这一块真的是死不还他们，但这一块的人本身也是想要回归爱尔兰的，所以他们一直跟他们打架，加上他们的宗教不一样，这边是天主教，这边是英国国教，就是新兴基督教，所以他们一直打架，到现在还在打，他们还是想要独立。
Each country has a local term for the population. While you can call them all British, it's not recommended as the four countries generally don't like each other. The Northern Irish, Scottish, and Welsh regard the English as slave-driving colonial masters. No matter that all three have their own devolved parliaments and are allowed to vote on English laws, despite the reverse not being true. And the English generally guard the rest as rural yokels who spend too much time with their sheep. However, as the four constituent countries don't have their own
passports,
they are all British citizens. But the
English
are right here. The area covered in black is Great Britain. Unlike England, Scotland, Ireland, Great Britain is a geographical rather than a political term. Great Britain is the largest island among the British Isles. Within the United Kingdom, Great Britain is often referred to England, Scotland, and Wales alone with the intentional exclusion of Northern Ireland. This is mostly, but not completely true, as all three constituent countries have islands that are not part of Great Britain, such as the Isle of Wight, part of England, the Welsh Isle of Anglesey, the Scottish Hebrides, the Shetland Islands, the Auckland Islands, and the Islands of the Clyde. The second biggest island in the British Isles is Ireland. It's worth noting at this point that Ireland is not a country. Like Great Britain, it's a geographical, not political term.
好，他说 Ireland, Scotland, England 这些都只是一个地理上的名词，不是这个国家的意思。好，因为这座岛它其实变成两个部分了。
The island of Ireland contains only two countries: Northern Ireland, which we have already discussed, and the Republic of Ireland. When people say they are Irish, they are referring to the Republic of Ireland, which is a separate country from the United Kingdom. However, both the Republic of Ireland and the United Kingdom are members of the European Union, even though England in particular likes to pretend that it's an island in the mid-Atlantic rather than 50 kilometers off the coast of France. But that's a story for another time. To review, the two largest islands in the British Isles are Ireland and Great Britain. Ireland has only two countries, the Republic of Ireland, while Great Britain mostly contains three, England, Scotland, and Wales. These last three, when combined, there are still many unanswered questions, such as why when you travel to Canada is there British royalty on the money? To answer this, we Let's talk about empire. You can't have gone to school in the English-speaking world without having learned that the British Empire once spanned a fourth.
这个就是日不落帝国，这些都是被英国人占领的强占的地方。离我们最近的是香港，上面还有这边一个在山东那附近吧，沈阳那附近有一个英国的租界，说租界都好听，其实是被抢过去的意思。People.
While it's easy to remember the parts of the British Empire that broke away violently, we often forget how many nations gained independence through diplomacy and bloodshed. These want-to-be nations struck a deal with the Empire, where they continue.
好，但请问澳洲邮差哪一个是澳洲国旗呢？是上面还是下面呢？上面是澳洲，那下面是纽西兰吧？对吧？他们都为什么都左上角都长一样？因为都是英。
Recognize the monarchy as the head of state in exchange for a local autonomous parliament. To understand how they are connected, we need to talk about the crown. Not the physical crown that sits behind glass in the Tower of London and earns millions of tourist pounds for the UK, but the crown is a complicated legal entity best thought of as a one-man corporation. Who created this corporation? God did. According to British tradition, all power is vested in God, and the monarch is crowned in a Christian ceremony. God, however...
国体还是政体，我不太清楚，但是讲君主这个东西，他们觉得是天父君权。Not
wanting to be bothered with micromanagement, conveniently delegates his power to an entity called the crown. While this used to be the physical crown in the Tower of London, it evolved over time into a legal corporation sole, able to be controlled only by the ruling monarch. It's a useful reminder that the United Kingdom is still technically a theocracy, with the reigning monarch acting as both the head of state and the supreme governor of the official state religion, Anglicanism. Such are the oddities that arise when dealing with a thousand-year-old monarchy. Back to Canada and the rest. The former colonies that gained their independence through diplomacy and continue to recognize the authority of the crown are known as the Commonwealth Realm. They are, in decreasing order of population, Canada, Australia, Papua New Guinea, New Zealand, Jamaica, the Solomon Islands, Belize, the Bahamas, Barbados, St. Lucia, St. Vincent and the Grenadines, Grenada, Antigua and Barbuda, St. Kitts and Nevis, and Tuvalu. All are independent nations, but still recognize the monarchy as the head.
刚刚他列举的这一些都是已经独立的了。好，但是呢，官方语言到现在还是都是英文。像我们的邦交国，史瓦济兰。 也是被英国占领过，后来他们也是很努力的独立了。官方语言是英文，他们的国王就说要恢复他们自己的语言，所以就变成并列，然后要改国名。他们说 Switzerland 是英国人给他们取的名字，我们不要，我们要去英化。It's
a nervous and Tuvalu. All are independent nations, but still recognize the monarchy as the head of state, even though it has little real power within their borders. There are three further entities that belong to the crown, and these are the crown dependencies, the Isle of Man, Jersey, and Guernsey. Unlike the Commonwealth realm, they are not considered independent nations, but are granted local autonomy by the crown and British citizenship by the United Kingdom. Though the UK does reserve the right to overrule the laws of their local assemblies. Are we done now? Almost, but not quite. There are still a couple of loose threads, such as this place. The tiny city of Gibraltar on the southern coast of Spain, famous for its rock, its monkeys, and for causing diplomatic tension between the United Kingdom and Spain. But what about the Falkland Islands, which caused so much tension between the United Kingdom and Argentina that they went to war over them? These places belong in the last group of Crown properties known as British Overseas Territories, but their former name, Crown Colonies, gives away their origin. They are the last vestiges of the British Empire.
好，他现在讲的就是，比如说西班牙南边有一座小城市，还有他刚刚的哪一个小岛？Between
the United Kingdom and Spain. But what about the Falkland Islands?
好，这个在阿根廷旁边的一个小岛，这些都是所谓的英属什么什么领地。
It caused so much tension between the United Kingdom and Argentina that they went to war over them. These places belong in the last group of Crown properties known as British Overseas Territories. But the former name of Crown Colonies gives away their origin. They are the last vestiges of the British Empire. Unlike the Commonwealth realm, they have not become independent nations and continue to rely on the United Kingdom for military and sometimes economic assistance. Like the Crown Dependencies, everyone born within their borders is a British citizen. The Crown Colonies are, in decreasing order of population, Bermuda, the Cayman Islands, the Turks and Caicos Islands, Gibraltar, the British Virgin Islands, Akrotiri and Dhekelia, Anguilla, St. Helena, the Ascension Islands, Tristan da Cunha, Montserrat, the British Indian Ocean Territory, the South Georgia and South Sandwich Islands, the Falkland Islands, the British Antarctic Territory, and the Pitcairn Islands. For our final Venn diagram, the United Kingdom is a country situated on the British Isles that is part of the Crown, which is controlled by the monarchy. Also part of the Crown and the British Isles are the Crown Dependencies. The independent nations of the former empire that still recognize the Crown are the Commonwealth realm, and the non-independent remnants of the former empire are the British Overseas Territories. Thank you very much for watching.
所以各位上完今天这堂课之后，应该就不会再说 England 就是英国。所以如果遇到老外 ，Where are you from？ Are you from England？ 他可能会回你不是 ，I'm from Scotland， 那是不同国家。他们彼此之间是没有好感的。英格兰人就觉得苏格兰人很怂，然后觉得威尔斯很乡下，反过来也是。 所以苏格兰人他们不喜欢被说是 English， 我也是也不喜欢。Okay, so these are the facts about England. I think it's almost time for our break. Shall we have a break? Okay, so let's have a break. Okay, so class. So let's move on to our reading part. Yeah, the passage is called Looking at England. So shall we read it together? If there are ideas about England, would you just read it? And the English that are...
England, that's not a problem.
pronounced red all the time. Okay, so their ideas about England and the English, they are just not true. 好，有一些关于英格兰跟英国人这个民族，我说一个混杂的这个民族，有一些刻板印象是不对的。Just not true. England does not stop for afternoon tea every day. 他们不是每天都喝下午茶，难道都不用工作吗？ Although the English do drink a lot of the liquid.好，这边的 do drink 会不会觉得怪怪的？为什么动词前面加个 do？ 强调，真的很爱喝。他真的喝很多这个液体耶 ，the liquid。liquid 是指这个液体吗？他说的这个液体指的是茶。好，他代指这个茶，然后呢 ，the 已经是指定嘛？哦，就是茶这个液体，不是酒这个液体。英文的 the 是很深奥的。Hot with milk， 一定是喝热的茶，然后还要加牛奶，红茶拿铁。And although the weather is very changeable, it doesn't rain all the time。好，虽然他们的天气非常的多变 ，changeable 多变 ，it doesn't rain all the time， 不是无时无刻都在下雨。好，那些说去伦敦会常常下雨的人，应该是没来过台北吧？真的，台北的雨日比伦敦多太多。如果你真的看数据的话，这是台北比较可怕。Okay, so next paragraph, shall we read it together? Also, there's a lot of good food in England. No, really. In the major cities, you'll find the cuisine of almost every nationality.Indian food is a popular favorite of the English. To find classic English food, try eating in a traditional pub. Also, there is a lot of good food in England. 好，他说英格兰其实很多好吃的。No, really, 这边的意思是没错就是这样。非常口语的说法，没错就是这样。In the major cities, what does it mean by in the major cities? 主要城市没有错，就是主要城市。You'll find the cuisine 料理啊，我们说食物有三种 ，food dish cuisine cuisine 是最好听的嘛，对不对 ？Of almost every nationality, of nationality 就指它的国籍，就是各国来的食物。Indian food is a particular favorite of the English. 好，英国人最爱吃的呢，可以算是印度菜了。哦，为什么会这样？会不会是因为印度曾经是他们最大的殖民地，所以他们才喜欢吃印度菜呢？有可能吗？To find classic English food, try eating in a traditional pub. 好，如果你真的想要吃很传统道地的英国料理的话，可以试试看在当地的小酒馆。那什么叫道地英国菜？我还是真的不知道。除了那个 fish and chip， 但我觉得那个也不是菜，那是垃圾食物吗？那这样说，好像鸡排也是垃圾食物。不要评论别人。Okay, so let's move on to next paragraph.然后前面的 particular 有问题吗？ particular， 刚看到有人有问题哈，尤其的意思，倒数第三句 particular 是尤其，好，他们尤其爱的是印度菜这样子。Okay, so next paragraph. The famous English politeness is everywhere. The English use please, thank you, and sorry more than most nationalities.For example, if you step on someone's foot, they'll probably say sorry to you. If you make a complaint, it's also common to begin with sorry, as in, sorry, but the soup is cold. Okay, the famous English politeness is everywhere. 英式的礼仪是到处可见的。好 polite.礼貌的 ，NESS 叫做抽象名词字尾，指礼貌这件事。Okay, also they may say manner. 那或者是你。 The English use please, thank you, and sorry more than most nationalities. 所以英国人说的请谢谢对不起比起他国家的人还要来得频繁，真的吗？跟欧洲人比起来吧，如果跟亚洲可能就他可能没去过日本，对不对 ？Okay. For example, if you step on someone's foot, they probably say sorry to you. 真的吗？你踩到别人，别人还跟你说对不起？ 我是不确定英国是不是这样，但我在日本的时候的确是这样。我撞到别人，他转过来跟我说对不起。嗯，他觉得是对不起，我不应该挡在你前面让你撞的概念。Okay, if you make a complaint, it's also common to begin with sorry, as in I'm sorry, but this soup is cold.
即使你要向别人抱怨要找人家吵架，你开头还是先道歉。哎，不好意思，那个汤好像有一点不是那么的温暖。
对不对？可是台湾人是，哎，汤是冷的，那干嘛？你会先顶对方更凶，民族性不一样。Okay, so final paragraph, which we just read it. You may think on the ground that people don't talk to each other, even when crowded together in the rush hour. Silence is normal as people read their books or newspapers. That doesn't mean English people are friendly. It just means you might have to get to know them first. Okay, so you may think it's strange on the London Underground. 好, Underground 大写的表示是这家公司，伦敦捷运公司。就像北捷，它叫伦捷。 杰伦，伦杰。That people don't talk to each other. 哎，在伦杰上面没有人会说话耶。Even when crowded together, what does mean by crowded together? 挤在一起，好字面上的翻译啊。好，真的就是挤在一起啊。他们挤在一块的时候也都不太说话哎。好，那 rush hour 后面的 rush hour 叫尖峰时段。 Silence is normal. Silence 指沉静、静默、安静这件事。好 ，ence 是名词哦。好，沉默是安是正常的，安静是正常的。As people read their books or newspapers, 这边的 as 叫做因为，因为人们都在读他们自己的书或是读报，所以当然不会说话。 那有些人觉得大都市里的人很冷漠，为什么搭车都不讲话？其实很大原因是根本不认识对方，为什么讲话？有的人说东京人搭地铁之后很安静，是很礼貌吗？但是我实际在那边生活过，我觉得不是那么一回事。他们如果是一群朋友一起搭捷运，还是聊天聊得比台湾大声啊。那东京人为什么你觉得他安静？是因为他们根本不认识对方，就不认识你，为什么要他们硬要逼他们聊天呢？好。 Okay, that doesn't mean English people are unfriendly. 不代表他们不友善，只是他们就是这样子安静而已。It just means you might have to get to know them first. 好 ，get to know， 试着了解他们。Okay, so any questions about the passage? No? So let's move on to question and answer. True or false? So question number one, the English don't like their tea to be hot. False, 不喜欢热茶。错，他们喜欢喝热茶。台湾人才喜欢喝冰茶吧？好奇怪的国家，明明台湾人的观念是不要喝冰的，可是偏偏我们都喝冰的热茶。的热茶本身应该是要热的，但台湾人把它变成冰的。但是而且我们的观念是喝冰的对身体不好。好，越不能做的事情越要做，这样越有快感。
请问一下，日本人是不是都喜欢喝冰？
对，他们的体质是不怕冰。对，他们进餐厅就是一杯冰块满满，然后加水，他们一定要喝冰水。对，那美国人也是，早上醒来先喝冰可乐。对我们来讲，可乐伤胃，然后冰点伤身体，可是体质不一样，他们是不会有任何问题的。对，他们也是啊，感冒的时候就是挖那个哈根达斯，就是冰啊，护身体。然后我跟日本人解释，台湾进餐厅为什么水都是温的，他们觉得好奇怪。他们问我啊，说为什么来台湾进餐厅坐下来，服务生上的水都是温水？我觉得这样好恶心哦，应该要喝冰水啊。他说温水就是只有在感冒吃感冒药的时候才是配温水。他说餐厅不是应该要上冰水？我说在我们的体质来讲，应该是台湾人比较适合喝温水，他们就不能接受，他们觉得。女生月经来也是都吃冰的都没差，他们都不会怎么样。所以台湾人其实体质蛮不好的，对，台湾人还蛮虚的，天气变一个话就感个冒。但是他们是日夜温差30度都不会生病。Okay, so question number two, you get a lot of different types of weather in England. 英国气候很多变吗？Yes, 像现在的气温那边可能不到20度，但是台湾已经热到快死掉。Okay, number three, Indian food is very popular in England. True. Number four, you can find typical English food in top restaurants. Not top restaurant in traditional pubs.Number one, the English often use sorry to begin a complaint. 要找人家吵架就先道歉。Okay, true. Number six, the English like to talk to strangers on the underground. False. 就不认识当然不会讲话嘛。Okay.Okay, so section 3. What do you think a short article about your country might mention? 这句话有点绕口，意思是如果现在有一篇文章要介绍台湾，你觉得这篇文章会提到哪些东西？像刚刚这边有四段，他就提了四个点。那如果是台湾的话，起码有三点你觉得一定会介绍台湾的。假设今天是日本人、美国人来台湾玩，他写一篇游记，你觉得他们一定会写什么？Yeah, 一定会写路边摊文化，对不对？然后一个路边摊会被警察赶，100个路边摊就把它变夜市，就不会被赶。所以凝聚力量大，对不对？先抢先赢，占地为王。还有吗？机车很多，但是日本人一定会写。我亲眼目睹在西门町的中心桥那个引道，往三重那个引道呢。机车超级多，对，大家都要挤上桥，然后就绿灯的时候，两个日本女生就是拿出手机狂拍，真的哎，哇，好多机车哦！我这辈子没看过这么多机车。从小到大，长大，从小时候到长大，遇过的机车都没有这么一次红绿灯这么多。对，然后日本有一个节目还真的来台湾的台北大桥拍那个尖峰时期的机车瀑布。荣登日本综艺节目的收视率冠军，超扯！他们真的没看过机车，然后他们会一直批评台湾的机车，我觉得这很不对。他们一直批评台湾机车太多什么，但他们没有想过台湾买车贵，因为日本自己造车，所以车很便宜。可是我们的进口车很贵，然后我们薪水很低，对，又没有停车位。但是日本是
从政策上就是做很多停车场，到处都有停车场，所以他们开车很方便。在他们气候啊，当然是要开车啊。如果下雪，台湾还能骑车吗？对，但是他们就一直骂我们台湾这样，这真的是嫌弃哦。从他们语言就可以听得出对这件事情是嫌弃还是褒。那很不巧，我都刚好听得懂，就我走在路上就听他们在批评台湾，我就。还有吗 ？Anything else？ Motorcycles or scooters, night market and
Taipei
101. Okay, that's probably, but that's not part of culture. 因为那个只是一个标的物，对，那只是一个地标。但是刚刚讲的机车，那是一个文化，夜市是个文化。还有没有什么是跟台湾文化？你觉得老外应该会写的 ？Yes, please.
搭电梯，这手扶梯一定排右边。
啊、
oh, ，
爱排队，我觉得排队是台湾人的坏文化。嗯，这个风潮从台北开始，到现在台中已经开始出现爱排的这个现象。还有吗？手扶梯喜欢站右边，这个国外好像也都这样，不知道。啊？台湾也没有强制说要站哪边啊，但是就是会有台北人很讨人厌，就是看到前面站左边，说你们中南部上来的吗？我就回答对啊，怎样？是真的。还有我朋友就是跟朋友一起走手扶梯，然后前面被人家挡住，他居然对我说：“哎、欸，你们中南部上来都很没有水准，就挡住别人的路吗？”
现在是有改了。
说可是明明法规就说是站稳踏阶啊，要你站稳啊。所以以前刚来台北的时候还蛮讨厌台北人的，现在不知不觉我也变台北人了，蛮讨人厌的。Anything else？ 他这边也提到了天气，如果你要写台湾的天气，你能怎么写？如果今天要你写一篇短文介绍台湾，你能写吗？有啦，台湾人蛮热情的。对老外来讲，台湾人还算热情，我觉得是好的。这个我同意，这个不是客套话。台湾人真的蛮热情的。台北人为什么很讨人厌？那是对台湾人，台北人对外国人很友善，对不对？你看宜兰人点头。你来台北多久呢？
6年。
你大学在这边念的吗？那你觉得台中人比较友善，还是台北人比较友善？当然是宜兰人比较友善，白问的。
台中比较友善。
台中比较友善是真的，是真的，非常好客。台北就是看屁啊这样。好，那还有吗？台北人，你请说。啊、oh, ，Taiwanese girls are easy， 是这样吗？有个老外写了一篇文章说，台湾的女生很好把，你不用吹飞之力，你只要走过去，她就跟你回家。Is it？ 这样是真的吗 ？Stacy， 你吃西餐吗？你吃西餐吗 ？Would you prefer Taiwanese man or like German man？Either will do. Okay. 好。那你会想要反驳那个说法吗 ？Taiwanese girls are easy. 哦，好，给你一个平反的机会，你有必要。Okay, so I think, yeah. Let's move on to the listening part. Okay, listening. So on section 4A, yeah, you are here three conversations and you have to decide the answer. So like number one, question would be, where does she want to go? And the other one, what does she want the driver to do? So are you ready?
Track 24. Conversation 1.
Do you go to Carson Street?
Yep.
How much is it?
$2.
Could you tell me when to get off?
Sure, no problem. Conversation 2.
24.
Conversation 1.
Do you go to Carson Street?
Yep.
How much is it?
$2.
Could you tell me when to get off?
Sure, no problem. Conversation.
Okay, so a woman and a bus driver. So where does the woman want to go? Carson
Street.
That's right. And what does she want the driver to do? Okay, she wants the driver to tell her when to get off. 下车前请告诉她，到站前告诉她。就三句话，四句话，结束了。
Conversation 2.
Do you need any help? Yes, please. Could you tell me if you have this in a size 4?
Sure. Let me go check.
Thanks.
再一次吗？要再一次吗？
Could you tell me when to get off?
Sure, no problem. Conversation 2.
Do you need any help? Yes, please. Could you tell me if you have this in a size 4?
Sure, let me go check.
Thanks.
So, what does the customer ask for? 他要求了什么东西？ Something in size 4. 他要买一个东西，但我不知道什么东西，他没有说。对不对 ？In size 4, 四号的，我猜可能是衣服。一号是最小件，正常人都穿三号吧，三四号左右。Okay, so what does the salesperson do? 这个店员做了什么事？他只说 OK, let me go check. 好，所以他要去找找看嘛。So the salesperson goes check. 好，这边省略一个 to 嘛， go to check, goes to check, let me go to check. So number 3. Conversation 3.
Hi, I need to go to 231 East Grand Street.
231 East Grand Street?
Yes. Do you know where that is?
Yep.
Okay. So where does the passenger want to go? A passenger and a taxi driver. 231. What street is it?Grand Street on the east. 好，格兰东街。好 ，East Grand Street， 或是东格兰街，听起来都很奇怪。Okay, and how about does the driver know where is it? Yeah, he knows where it is. Okay. Ready? 再听一次。
Grand Street.
231 East Grand Street?
Yes. Do you know where that is?
Yep.
So, 司机知道在哪里吗？
Yep.
Huh?
Station 3.
Hi, I need to go to 231 East Grand Street.
这是乘客.
231 East Grand Street?
这是司机.
Yes. Do you know where that is?
Yep.
Yep. 所以到底是谁说要去? 到底是谁说 yep? 我们看一下对话好了. Okay, so that's on page 141. M2是乘客, 然后呢, M3是司机, 所以司机说 yeah, 所以司机知道怎么去。 好, OK, 再来我们回来看课文, 还有20分钟, 20分钟刚好进行 speaking, 在43页, 这个. So speaking 7. So you're going to interview a classmate for a market research company. Choose a topic from the box. 假设你现在要做一个市场调查，那你要访谈，要访问。好，这边有六个 topic, 6 topics in the chart. First one, free time activities. 你问对方的兴趣是什么? Internet use, 平均上网的习惯呢? Okay, number 3, favorite movies, 喜欢看哪一类的电影? Vacations, 假期都去哪儿玩? And shopping, 喜欢买什么, 买不买的多? And food, 都吃什么, 喜欢吃什么? 这样子, 那你问的时候要怎么问呢? 用下面绿色框框, 好，要礼貌一点啊。 Use polite words. 好，你问问题，你直接说，把问题讲出来，其实不礼貌。用一些礼貌的字，例如说 ，Excuse me, could I ask you a few questions? 可以让我耽误你几秒钟吗 ？Okay, could you say that again, please? 诶，听不清楚，你可以再说一次吗？你直接说 Pardon 也可以，但就是很直接，哈的意思。 好, could you say that again? 可以请你再重复一遍吗? 好, 那你要怎么礼貌? 第二种方式是你用间接问句，对不对? 刚刚说, how much is it? 这多少？这多少？ 跟, 不好意思，我借问一下，这多少？对不对? 就是废话的意思, 你多讲一些废话, could you tell me what kinds of movie you like? 这样子, 好。 挑一下, 那一样我们待会是小组小组, 不要让你两个两个, 两个两个其实有压力, 你就小组, 那你一个人问两个人, 这样可以吗? 好, 那你不用问太多, 因为快下课了, 待会又讲不完, 应该聊天, 对不对? 好, 你三, 假设你同一组的人, 就不要选一样的主题, 那这边三个, 四个, 四个, 三个, 三个, 你, 到, 这组，这组，这组。老师，我要先走。哦，好好好，好，那你刚好补这边。拜拜拜拜，下周见。好，那你们要先协调一下主题，不要跳一样的。主题不要跳一样啊。好。啊？
是你们是主任，还是你们要求？是，
一个人不能跟他shopping，不能。
你这下都是自己来一个。
好，shopping。
记得用礼貌用语啊 Could I? Would you? May I? Excuse me, miss. Could I ask you some questions? What kind of food do you like? Could you tell me what kind of food you like? Could I? Would you? May I?
Thank you. How many hours you spend on purchasing the equipment? Marvel. I like,
Okay, so I think this is the end of our class today.